Hi guys, it's Chief, and today we are going to. I don't know, I stopped building my big ship because it's gotten too laggy to a point where just I can't do anything anymore. So basically what I end up doing is just leaving all of my little builds in one place, and whenever they fix the rendering system, I'm either going to build another bigger ship or I probably will build a new one. Because of the heavy armor, so I'll just show you some of my builds. I think you guys seen some of it. So this is my original build that I'm using as a test base now. That's my little default fighter that I've settled on. I changed a few things on it. So right now there's four missile pods and five machine guns. This was the, I don't know. This was my first build, and I really didn't like it. It was much bigger and it was much slower, and it has about the same firepower, a little bit more, but I don't like it. Anyway, space jetpack on. Okay, so this is what I settled on the heavy fighter. I originally built a similar thing, I just made it bigger and have more weapons on it and more engine power. This is my little constructor bot. It has little bit missile pods on it, but it's basically, as you can see, landing struts. I guess I can replace them with different things, but it's just a really, really big. A ship with a lot of boosters and it could move things around. So yeah. And yeah, you see there's three big things here. I'll explain them later. And last thing I want to show you before I get to those three things is this thing. I always wanted to build a mining ship. So this is my bigger version of the mining ship. So as you can see, there's two mining arms, there's two rocket pods that could take out. Well, it's meant to shoot out any bigger things that's just that if I wanted to just make it quicker and move things like shoot blow things out of the way. It's pretty nimble. So basically my idea is it needs to be nimble. It needs to get to place from place one to place two from A to B really really quickly. So just a bunch of storage bins on top. Hopefully this is enough to store a lot of things. So my friend gave me a similar something that looked like this at first, and I'll get back to this first. So first of all, I built two mechs, and as you can see, my platform looks different. So this is a new heavy armor. The one with the camel pattern is the new heavy armor. It's supposedly four pieces of regular armor is equivalent to the armor of one heavy armor, and they're a lot heavier, but for some reason on smaller ships they're not, they're lighter. So here's my first mech, giant mech I've built. So pretty much, since I'm not saving this, I can show you what they do. Let's get into this one first. So this is, as you can see, actually, I'm gonna copy this one. Copy and paste. Okay, whoa, whoops. Okay, maybe I should turn one on. Oh, jetpack, where are you going? Thank God I'm not saving this. Okay. Let me in. No. I mean, cockpit. Stupid jetpack. No. As you can see, the rendering system still have a lot of issues. I don't have that much stuff, and this is actually all caused by lag. My jetpack all going crazy and stuff. So I don't know what's going on, but here we go. Okay, so I'm going to get out now and make a copy of this so I can show you guys. Copy. Okay. Paste. Did you fly off? No. Okay, good. Oh, I'm flying off. No. Okay. So, I'll use one to destroy the other, and then so on and so forth. So, I'm gonna, if I can ever get down from here, I'll show you guys what I'm talking about. Oh, this is hell getting into this stupid mech. Okay. Yay! Oh, right. So, I'll use this one to destroy that one. Pretty much it's just rockets and machine guns. Let's see. So, first of all, we'll use machine gun. So, the front of the hall, if I turn it around, these are mostly machine guns. And as you can see, there's actually, I didn't turn the lights on. If you turn the lights on and leave the beacon at the same time, it's so blinding that you can, it literally just blinds people. That's one of the defensive mechanisms, of course. The other thing is, as you can see on my arm and some of the parts of my ship, there's spikes everywhere. These spikes are actually extra layer of armor. It counts as extra layer, but of course it's much, much lighter. So that's defense number two. So without further ado, I'll show you what the machine gun look like and there. So now I'm sort of straight. So now you have these little indicator lights on where you're firing. So there's a machine gun. Pretty cool. So this is to deter any, anything that gets too close. But machine gun isn't the fun part. The fun part is, of course, this. So there's so many missile pods on this thing, it's crazy. So here we go. One fire. So there you go, guys. my first attempt to build a giant mech. So this is one mech. Okay. Well, the second mech is a little bit different, as you can see. It looks. I don't know if you guys ever watched Gundam Wing. There's one part of it where they build two Gundams that are trying. Well, they build two robots or Gundams or whatever. Mobile suits. Yeah, that's what they're called. Mobile suits that's built based on the Gundam pilot's profile. I forgot what they're called, but so one is blue, one is red. That's where it gave me the concept. And as you can see, this mech is built out of heavy armor. And basically, if I can stop in the front, screw it. There. So basically, there's two weapon systems. As you can see, there's a giant arm full of missile pods, and then there's a shield. It's five or six layer of heavy armor. So this shield is gonna withstand a lot of hits, and plus the head of it is drill bits. For some reason, the drills can take a ridiculous amount of punishment. So you guys all know what missile can do, so I'm not even gonna bother showing you guys that. I am, however, going to show you guys what if I can ever. Can I? Ooh, look at that. Okay. So, I am going to show you guys the drill weapon for this ship. So here's the earlier mech. Drill's on. Maybe I should. Yeah, there you go. See, when the drill turns on, the ship starts to vibrate. So let's see. And as you can see, the armor, the cockpit is pretty well armored. We'll see the destruction of the ship in a second. So here we go. The arm came off. Okay, we're gonna back off a little bit. Let's see how we did. So pretty much half the ship is gone. Pretty quick, pretty handy weapon when we ran out of ammunition. If there is ammunition in this game, of course. And let's see. We're gonna back up a little bit. And the reason why is I wanted to show you guys the shield. So the shield actually didn't take much damage at all, even though it rammed into half of that robot. So I don't really care. So as you can see, even though I bumped a little bit, normally under normal circumstance, that's probably not going to be a good thing, because then you'll probably broke a few things. So, yeah. That's that. Now, this ship, the other one, this big one over here, think, oh, crap. A few things I need to do to this. First of all, I need to, if I can ever get my this guy to stop moving. Okay. Now, I started a new world, and hopefully this one doesn't lag. It has some of my ships, but, yeah. Anyhow, so this ship, as you can see, it has drills. It looked like a plane, and it has wings and everything. And there's a reason why those two machine guns are there. It's to guide the bombs. So I built a kinetic weapon on this ship. So as you can see, rocket pods and machine guns, lots and lots and lots of them, and lights in the front. I realized the lights is a pretty good thing because it really just blinds things. But let's take off. So it moved a little bit, but it didn't move. The reason why they were attached is because then I can copy and paste this ship as many times as I want, and I didn't have to reattach the bombs because they're not easy to attach. So let's get into the ship and lock these things in carefully so I don't move the ship and make the bomb fly away. So did I do it right? Let's see. Yep, they're locked in place. So, we're going to use this red ship as a test. And if he will stop moving. So, basically, so if I turn the machine guns on, the ship doesn't turn very well. So, you can see, so there's all of these lights, but the two little dots on the side are where the bomb's gonna hit. So let's. It still lags for some reason. And of course, one of them fell off. But for the test, we'll just try the other one. Full speed, release, go up. Alright, so. As you can see, the bomb actually hit pretty well, other than the one that fell off. But landing struts in this game, there has to be a better way to attach weapons, but I think that they just haven't, implemented into the game yet. But let's see how we did. So that is one bomb into one layer of armor. Not bad. The hole's pretty big. Can't expect. Yeah, you can't really expect. That's a pretty good result to such a big ship. I mean, yes, that ship is huge, but the bomb really isn't that big. So let's try another one. There. And please don't blow away. Alright. So. Let go of you. And let go of you. We'll delete a couple of blocks so they don't run into each other. Okay, this time I'm gonna try to do a little bit better and actually attach the bomb a little bit better. So here we go. So let's see, bombs attached, machine guns on. I'm gonna turn slower this time. Oh, so then the bomb doesn't get ripped off. Okay, and facing the ship, we're going to go up and back. So we get some speed and we get a good angle of running at it, and now we don't break off these bombs. Here we go. Okay, I think that's far enough. Okay, let's see. So, maybe back up a little bit more. As you can see, this ship actually, even though it's so heavy, it flies quite fast. So, let's see. Here we go. Aim for the engine deck. Let go of the weapon. Sort of saw the impact. Let's see how we did. Thank God you fly pretty fast in your spacesuit. So, second test. So, we hit this one. I think we hit the same hold again. But the second bomb exploded here. And, yeah. Well, the engine's completely gone. And we went through one block and went through most of these and almost got to the door. So it's pretty devastating. And for such a small weapon, look at the explosive area. So we blew up here with two bombs. The second one didn't do too much damage because the first one already did a lot. Second one actually did. So look, it's gotten all the way to these. So this is like two layers. Yeah. And it even had took a little bit of damage on the side of this engine block here. So yeah. Think it's pretty useful. I just have to do better designs, maybe even bigger bombs or something, but this is just, like I said, all of those little ships are just test ships. So yeah, I call it a success. Now let's have a little fun. Let me in. Crazy ship, let me in. All right, now for the real weapon. Oh yeah, see this? Let's get on top of this ship. Hey Nat, thanks for the idea. This is what it does. Here we go. Look at it go. Oh, well. Here you go. Eventually, I mean, it's gonna hit the side of the ship, and that's what break it apart. But oh yeah, we'll go. There we go. I mean, if it was bigger, it'll worked out better. But and look at it. None of it broke off, even though, you know. So yeah. I was using it to grind up like head of like surfaces of these asteroids to make space bases. So I think it worked out quite well. Anyway, we'll see eventually how this works out. I might end up building like a space fort, space base here or something, because this seems like a pretty good platform. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and if you like, please subscribe to my channel, and you guys all have fun.